Our main objective is the identification of multi-epitope vaccine candidates against human leishmaniasis by evaluating their immunogenic potential in individuals with cured individuals cured from leishmaniasis due to leishmania major. Important cytokines such as interferon gamma and IL-10 were quantified by ELISA after PBMC stimulation of peptide pools. Also, T-cell phenotype were performed by flow cytometry. So, leishmaniasis is a disease caused by leishmania parasites which are transmitted by the same flies. Current treatments are toxic, expensive, and induce resistance. Vaccination could be an effective way to control this disease. However, to date, no human prophylactic vaccine is available now. Vaccination is feasible since healing is induced resistance to reinfections due to the development of memory T cells specific to leishmania antigens associated with cytokines associated with protection such as interferon gamma and relancin B. So there is different vaccination strategies which are used against leishmaniasis. Among them, peptide-based vaccines, which are considered to be a very attractive strategy. So peptide-based vaccine based on identification of epitopes from a protein candidate by using in silico approach. So to ensure a global population coverage, we can use the multi-epitope peptides, which is composed by several epitopes that bind different HLA molecules to ensure a global coverage. So peptide-based vaccines have many advantages, such as avoiding the in vitro culture of pathogens. They are easy to produce and they are safe. Now there is many peptide vaccines are in development against a lot of diseases. So in the present work, we are going to use a multi-epitope peptides, 11 multi-epitope peptides, which are selected from leishmania proteins. These proteins are well conserved within leishmania species, and they are able to elicit T-cell-mediated responses associated with protective immunity in both mice and humans. So these multi-epitope peptides present a high HLA binding affinity, and they are designed by bioinformatic tools from three leishmania proteins. The first one is the histone protein H2B, and leishmania major large fragile DPS, and promastigot surface antigens. So these peptides can bind both HLA molecule class 1 and 2, plus the length of peptides comprised from 18 to 14 amino acids, and each peptide contains 4 to 20 epitopes. So finally, with these peptides, we combine it to have 26 pools of peptides to test their immunogenicity in two groups of individuals. The first group is composed of 31 cure-resistant leishmaniasis, which are selected from the center of Tunisia, and the second group is constituted by 20 naive individuals, which are selected from the north of Tunisia. Peptides vaccines, the PBMC of these individuals are stimulated with peptide vaccine, and they are maintained in culture for 10 days in the presence of IL-2. So we quantified interferon gamma and ELISA in culture supernature. Also, stimulated cells were collected, washed, and re-stimulated with peptide pool to do a phenotype analysis by flow cytometry. So for calcification of interferon gamma in cured individuals with compared non-stimulated culture against stimulated culture. As we see, among the 26 pools used, only 17 pools induced significant interferon gamma levels in cured individuals, of course. So the next graph shows the comparison between cured group and naive group. As we can see that the 17 pools induced only interferon gamma in cured individuals, but not in naive individuals. So that shows that the immune response detected is only specific to Leishmania parasite. So here, this graph shows the level of IL-10 in both groups, in cured and naive. So as we can see, there is no IL-10 protection in both groups, individuals, cured and naive. No IL-10. Later, we selected the highest pools which induced the strongest interferon gamma level to T cell phenotype. So we phenotype activated memory T cells, as well as T cells secrete interferon gamma and granzyme B, which are the main cytokines which control the infectious diseases. So as we can see, this figure shows the percentage of activated memory T cells in cured individuals. The first, is the percentage of activated CD4 memory T cells. As you can see, after PBMC stimulation with peptides full, there is an increase in peptides in the percentage of memory activated memory CD4. And also for activated memory CD8, there is an increase of the percentage of activated CD8 after PBMC stimulation in cured individuals. These results are preliminary because it was only used for 5 individuals. So we are waiting to have more experiments to confirm this result. So this graph shows the T cells secreted interferon gamma after PBMC stimulation in cured individuals. As you can see, there is an increase in the percentage of CD8 and CD4 secreted interferon gamma after PBMC stimulation. So we didn't reach yet the significance because we used only 5 individuals. So concern T-cell secreting granzyme B, we observe that one of peptide pools used induced the increase of the percentage of CD8 T-cell secreting granzyme B. So to conclude, among 26 pools used, we have only 17 pools which are able to induce a high and specific interferon gamma response, only in individuals cured from Leishmania major. So the observed result show that the immune response is only specific to Leishmania parasite. It is interesting to note that all pools induce a high and significant interferon gamma response contain in common peptides derived from histone protein H2B. So we can conclude that peptides derived from H2B seems to be essential for better interferon gamma response. Only we conclude that we didn't have IL-10 production after peptide stimulation in both groups, cured and naive. It shows that our peptide pool induced a dominant TH1 profile. only we see that the strongest pool are associated with an increase in activated memory CD4 and CD8 T cell producing at interferon gamma. And we observe too a significant level of intracellular granzyme B in CD8 T cells after stimulation with one pool. So we are planning to evaluate memory T cells phenotypes such as central and effector memory T cells in response to peptide pool stimulation in pluripotent individuals. Also, we are planning to perform X-POD tests and HLA type of individuals. And we are planning to quantify other cytokines associated with protection such as TNF-alpha, IL-12, anti-IL-2 by cytometric reach array. I would like to thank my supervisor, Professor Ahmed Ghanemi, also my supervisor, Dr. Rachel Barre-Gonzalez and Dr. Jean-Loup, and I am grateful to Professor Karim Moon and Dr. Abdelhamid Kidab for selection and recruitment of current Leishmaniasis individuals. Thank you for your attention.